is stepping onto the stage. You can hear plenty of wood frogs behind me, and of course, spring peepers. How you guys doing? Chris Ignato here. You are watching Nature Now. So I want to apologize that I haven't uploaded any videos for the past few weeks. Had difficulties in my personal life, and I had a spinal tap done recently, and it did not go well. I've been leaking spinal fluid, and it is extremely uncomfortable. Today's my first day I can get out, and I've had to stop by the bank and do stuff. But you know what else is leaking? The clouds. You can hear plenty of wood frogs here and spring peepers. Spring is definitely stepping up to the stage. See all those wood frogs going around in there? Lots of them. I wish I had my waders. Nothing quite compares to a northeastern vernal pool in March or April. Just activity all over the place. Come nighttime, especially if it's a dark, rainy night, you'll have the salamander migrations at this time of year. As long as we have a few nights above, say, 45 degrees and it's dark and rainy, you'll have the spotted salamanders coming out to breed. Not in this park, there's not really any hills or rocks, but you find a deciduous woodland with some hills and rocks and some vernal pools in them, you got a good chance of spotting some spotted salamanders. So what's amazing about this is in another couple of days or so, the temperature could just drop below freezing. You know, you could have some really cold nights. We could even have some snow. All this activity would just stop. You know, the concert would be closed and open upon further notice. But until then, these peepers and these wood frogs are putting on quite the show. So as you can tell, the males outnumber the females. So anytime there's movement, all the males will dart for them. A funny story is, while trying to get photographs of these guys, years ago, every time I reached down in the water to move a twig or something, a lot of males would rush for my hand and try to mate with it. I had amplexus with my hand and some male wood frogs. And let me tell you, trying to shake those guys off isn't as easy as you think. I have sympathy for some of you women out there. One other cool fact is the males will get here first, of course, to get a jump on the season. No pun intended. And what happens is they'll try to establish their small territories and everything before the females get here. Then the females will emerge, you know, from the landscape, hear the vernal pools because of all this racket, and come on down looking for their mates. Cool thing about spring peepers and wood frogs, among a couple other species of frog in the world, they have almost an antifreeze in their blood. Some of them use glucose, other ones use alcohol, and that allows them to be above the frost line without perishing. A lot of frogs, if they are above the frost line, when the ground freezes, it can kill them. Not these guys. You know, the last thing to freeze in them is usually their liver, the first thing to thaw out will be the liver, and it'll pump blood and antifreeze into the other organs and stuff. It's a long process. I have a video of it. So these wood frogs are being very cooperative. They're actually sitting still and singing. A lot of time they'll actually swim as they sing, and it's very difficult for me to get the shot that I want. But wood frogs are cool because they have two vocal sacs on either side of their body, and they inflate them, and that's how they amplify their call. Different species, like the spring peeper, they'll inflate their chin. That's where their vocal sac is. It's different for each species, and it's a lot of fun seeing how each species does its call and amplifies that song. This is pretty exciting stuff, and I really hope I get to hit these vernals with my girlfriend. I really want her to see wood frogs for the first time and get to experience their eggs, which are just amazing looking. They're so glassy and shiny and clear. They're just gorgeous. And they're just a riot. They're a lot of fun. So let's get back to filming. So here we've got two wood frogs in amplexus, which is what you call it when they are coupled up and mating, or partnered up, whatever you want to say. It's called amplexus. Now, it's almost always the case the female is larger, and they're almost always like a rusty orange color, at least in my locale. So once they're paired up like that, if another male comes along, the first male will just kick away or defend his female from the other males. And often, which is kind of cool, the female will also kick away other suitors if she's already in amplexus with another male. So kind of cool, kind of funny to watch. So there's the larger female on the bottom, and there's the male on top holding on. He's not going to pass her up for anybody. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little teaser video. You know, it definitely sounds like spring is about to hit hard. We got a couple weeks before it's officially here, and these peepers and wood frogs are amazing. I'm sorry I've been away for a while. Hopefully things will get better after the spinal tap. You know, they're checking to see if I have Lyme disease in my brain, because I keep testing positive and I have symptoms just all over the place. So thanks a lot for bearing with me. Once again, I'm Chris Ignato, signing out.
Thanks a lot for watching, and remember, if you like this video, be sure to check out this video over here that YouTube has selected specifically for you based on your watch time. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button, but you gotta click the bell icon, because if you don't, YouTube will never let you know when a new video of mine comes out. And remember, passion inspires spirit.